back to the episode of Ask Dr. Nick. My name is Dr. Nick Schmidlkoffer, and I work for the Neurologic Wellness Institute. Today's question is there a best diet for mental health or mental health conditions? And I think this one is really interesting to me. I'm going to start off right away by saying I have a bias in this one. I am somebody who really enjoys meat, and I really think that meat is the best food on the planet for humans, and that's because it has the most nutrient-dense properties, and it doesn't have any anti-nutrients. Therefore, we're going to get everything that we need from eating meat and drinking good mineralized water, and we don't necessarily need a ton of fruits and vegetables, let's say. And so that is my bias. My bias is I think meat is very nutritionally beneficial. I think growing good regeneratively raised meat is good for the environment, and even ethically, eating meat is good because we need to feed ourselves, and we are still we are growing and raising maybe cattle in the best living conditions, and they're not going to be maybe attacked by wolves or bears or other things that are going to eat them alive. So again, there's my bias. Okay, so now the three articles I'm going to talk about today are how vegetarian-based diets or diets that mostly exclude meat can predispose somebody to mental health disorders like depression and anxiety. And the main point I want to drive here is that the reason why this happens is because a lot of times vegetarian diets are nutrient poor. And especially there's some key nutrients that are needed for the brain and for decreased inflammation. And if we don't have those, that can reduce someone's energy. It can decrease how to utilize fats, therefore increase inflammation. And then by increased inflammation, it causes brain or neuro-inflammation, leading to a lot of these depressive and anxiety symptoms. So, we got three articles. We'll talk mostly about the first one. And then I'll just bring out other points of some other ones, and maybe be a little devil's advocate with it as well. So, this first one is called Meat and Mental Health, a Systematic Review of Meat Abstinence and Depression, Anxiety, and Related Phenomenon. I believe it's a relatively recent paper. Where is that? From 2020. Yes. Okay, 2020 paper. Okay, so here is the abstract. Basically, they're looking at a meta-analysis or a systematic review of examining the psychological health in meat consumers versus meat abstainers. And so they looked at 18 studies, 160,000 participants, with 149,000 being meat consumers versus about 8,500 being meat abstainers, from 11 to 96 years old, multiple geographic regions. Okay, 11 of the 18 studies showed that meat abstinence was associated with a poorer psychological health. Four studies were basically equivocal, basically saying no effect. And three studies showed that meat abstainers actually had better outcomes with this mental health. And so the most rigorous studies, though, demonstrated that the prevalence of risk of depression and anxiety were significantly in participants who avoided meat consumption. So basically saying that the ones that showed that meat abstainers, the ones that did not eat meat, had better outcomes, weren't really the best studies. And the ones that were more rigorous, better studies showed that vegetarians or those people that did not eat meat were more likely to have depression and anxiety. The majority of the studies, especially the higher quality ones, showed that those who avoided meat consumption had significantly higher rates of risk of depression, anxiety, and or self-harm behaviors. Okay, so the reason why this I think is so important is because becoming a vegetarian or a vegan is a very popular thing to do for one's health. And I think any choice to change one's diet or lifestyle is huge, and I commend anybody for making a choice to do that. A lot of times people go from a highly processed food diet with a lot of sugar, and and become a vegetarian. It's like, that is great. You're making a decision for your health that will be better for you. However, long term, there with being on a vegetarian diet, you lose a lot of nutrients. You do not get many nutrients, specifically some B vitamins, carnitine, creatine, and there's multiple others. So, and this is where up here it talks about that the paper in the STAR talks about how there's other lifestyle factors that may actually be beneficial for why vegetarianism gets maybe a better status. About they change their physical activity, they decrease alcohol and drug consumption, and someone may be decreasing tobacco products. But here, this is the problem. When we abstain from meat, we have nutritional deficiencies. We lose out on vitamin B12, only can get from meat. Vitamin D, which obviously you can get from the sun as well. Omega-3 fatty acids, specifically the EPA and DHA that we can only get in meat and fish. We can't get omega-3 fatty acids, EPA and DHA in plants. We get a different type of omega-3, and not many are converted. We don't get high amounts of calcium, iron, and zinc in vegetables. Especially all three of these ions can bind to phytates and lectins and oxalates and prevent absorption, which are in multiple vegetables. And so these are much higher in meat and animal products, and so therefore these are essential for when it comes to anemia or getting good blood flow to the brain, zinc for our immune system. Okay, a couple of things that aren't on here are the main supplements or the main vitamins that are only in, actually they're the more nutrients, the main nutrients that are only in animal products, like creatine for energy, carnitine, which low rates of carnitine have been identified in patients with depression, and then choline, which is really important for the brain, and low rates of choline lead to dementia. So just really big products here, parts here that I think need to be addressed for people who are looking to go maybe towards a vegetarian diet or to stop consuming meat. So looking at that, now let's look at a couple other studies. This one's from 2012, Vegetarian Diet and Mental Health Disorders. So it's a much smaller study. They looked at completely vegetarian versus predominantly vegetarian, and then non-vegetarian people, much more than non-vegetarian. And then some here of the non-vegetarian, but they were matched completely to the socio-demographic of the vegetarian group. Okay, and they found that vegetarians still displayed elevated prevalence rates of depression disorders, anxiety disorders, and somatoform disorders. Okay, and that they did with, because of this matching, they can't say that it was due to like higher rates of females being vegetarian, or that they're predominantly residing in urban areas, or that they're mostly single people that are vegetarians. They can't say it has to do to that. But they said here, the conclusion, in the Western cultures, vegetarian diet is associated with this elevated risk of mental disorders. Okay. So now you're going to say, maybe, well, how do we know that it's specifically that people are abstaining from meat and that can predispose us to mental disorders? Now, obviously, I'm not saying it's a cause, but I'm saying that these lack of nutrients plus maybe something else that's going on in our environment, whether that be high stress, post-traumatic stress, emotional trauma, all those things can all be related. And so with this study, it kind of describes that a little bit. So depressive symptoms and vegetarian diets, they had, it's from 2018. They did look at a lot of subjects, which is cool, 90,000. The diet they looked at was omnivorous, pesco-vegetarian, lacto-ovo-vegetarian, and vegan. And they saw that depressive symptoms were associated with pesco-vegetarian and lacto-ovo-vegetarian diets, especially when those diets had low legume intake, which is interesting. Legumes, technically, they are more fiber. They can help get rid of maybe excess estrogen that is building up in the body. But then, what I like here is that they said the exclusion of any food group. So if they excluded meat, or if you excluded fish, or if you ate meat and fish and you excluded vegetables, that can all lead to more rates of anxiety and depression. And so, this is just a good way to look at things, like, even though when we stop eating something that may be culturally there or maybe something that we should be eating as a human, and I'm not saying like processed food. A lot of processed food is brand new to our diet as our evolution in humans. But if we're kind of excluding something that is naturally found in nature, fruit, vegetables, meat, honey, obviously water, any of those things, maybe some herbs, then that can lead to just some higher rates of depression and mental health issues. And this can be, you know, anxiety provoking. If somebody says you shouldn't be eating that because it's bad for your health, and then it's like every time you eat it, you feel bad about yourself. So then you decide to completely abstain from it. And this is where I think part of that predisposition happens. And so I guess I would just like to urge people here. I would just like to urge people to not necessarily exclude anything from their diet, but to think about what they're eating. And everything that you're putting in your mouth is either going to hurt you or help you. And in that case, I think everything that we can do, whole food based, non-processed food, more organic, less pesticides, regeneratively raised animals that are not only better nutrition, but also better for the environment. By incorporating all of these things into your diet, you can have a more robust and colorful and interesting diet, especially if you include organ meats, and which I do love, and that can help promote good health, both mentally and physically. And so, just real briefly, my diet consists of a lot of different kinds of meats, especially beef. And then some chicken and pork, some fish. But in the beef, I do eat every part of the animal. There's no waste. I drink bone broth. I eat liver and kidneys and other organs among the muscle meat fat. And then a lot of fat from them as well. And then I eat a few amount of vegetables, okay, here and there. Ones that, like mostly like romaine lettuce, asparagus, cucumbers. And then I eat, you know, fruit like avocados and olives, and then a lot of like more sugary fruit like apples and some bananas, kiwi, grapes, blueberries, a lot of berries in general. And that's mostly my diet. And most of it is more animal based or meat based. So again, this is my bias, and this is my take on things. So I hope people enjoyed this one. I would love to see comments and people to converse about this topic. And if you have any suggestions for future topics, I would love to hear them. Thanks again. Stay healthy and have a great day.